The Pokemon community for the past few years has been a lot like politics divided, if you will. But it can't be helped, just like politics, because you have a lot of bad actors, let alone fake heroes, that love to prey on impressionable people. That's the thing, isn't it? People have been biting the bait for quite some time now. It's crazy to think that grown people cry about other people playing their games how they want to. Sure, I guess they're getting clout for cheating, but I mean, if it's working, then kudos to them. I play legit and have not cheated in any of my Pokemon games. Just play how you want to play and let people play how they want to play. It's not the end of the world, it's a game. Now we all know what I'm alluding to. This shit gets old after a while. And quite frankly, I think my audience, yes, all of you viewers of all shapes, sizes, and colors deserve so much better than the same tired and brain dead shit, regardless of how much it's roasted into a savage oblivion. But listen to these two sentences right here. I play legit and have not cheated in any of my Pokemon games, and it's not the end of the world. There's this shitty stigma in the Pokemon community. All of this petty, childish, and stupid shit that's been running through the Pokemon community like diarrhea for the past nearly decade now. Just do you. Whoever said you needed a community, and anyone for that matter, to live a healthy and happy life? If anything, you should learn from all of these bitchy, whiny, bitter, and miserable little fucks on how not to live your life based off of the internet, let alone a child's video game. Who cares if someone hacks? Who cares how someone plays a video game? Who cares if you enjoy Nuzlocke's, play by Smogon rules? Do what makes you happy. This is not a knock on your morals. As I sift through all of the drama that has been manufactured through the Pokemon community for nearly a decade now, I can't help but to laugh my ass off at these unironic projectors. These are the most self-entitled shitheads in the Pokemon community that you should be watching out for. Creating their own demons and then turning around bitching about why they can't enjoy anything and why their little pathetic world is any kind of threatened. But yet they can't look in a single fucking mirror and see where they dedicate their two brain cells, energy, and time. I have a literal emporium on this clout chaser, this bad actor, this fake ass hero. This is exactly what I'm talking about. What does it need saving from? Ah, that's right. For nearly a decade now, it's the same tired ass character assassinating and morally correct echo chamber, propaganda, agenda, and narratives he has been regurgitating for, again, nearly a fucking decade. There's always something wrong with the Pokemon community, much like he always manufactures everything that's wrong with the Pokemon community. Holy shit, will I ever stop scrolling?
When? Why can't the world revolve around me?
A literal career criminal and manufacturing the same drama. Why is there never anything good said about the Pokemon community? It's up to you to avoid drama mongers. That's all people like this are. We all know that Publicify is a self-entitled, delusional, and clout-chasing gatekeeper and cry bully with a god complex, still desperately scraping for validation after nearly a, say it with me, decade. And you have to question these so-called heroes when they're always crying about how everyone else is the problem, but they never say a single thing that's wrong with them. Oh, and you can't forget the equally brain dead
Pokemon Legends Arceus will fail
echo chamber as well. This kid rehashed the same video across 15 other videos and even made a playlist out of it, spouting the same baseless garbage.
It's gonna be all the problems you had in the other Pokemon games because contrarian logic forces me to hate the things that you love and love the things that you hate. I'm really trying to convince myself that this game is going to be as bad as I'm trying so hard to make it be.
Remember guys, if you have any kind of criticisms about Game Freak and the Pokemon games, you're not a true Pokemon fan. Publicify's well-documented hypocrisy, projection, contrarianism, and then some says everything you need to know about that fraud, which is why he's a world-class projector. Every single Pokemon Legends Arceus shitpost he has posted and will inevitably shitpost in the future to milk ad revenue off of can be summed up as him saying this.
Logic, where art thou in my Pokemon game? Suddenly it matters. I'm trying to attach and pull logic out of a video game. Imagine how intellectual I just became. Suddenly logic matters in video games. The phone's bad. The lore's bad. The logic is bad. The phone's bad. The lore's bad. The logic is bad. The phone's bad. The lore's bad. The logic is bad. Oh, I just said the same thing 3 times in the your woe? I thought I said something different, intelligent, and at all, because the tweeds and sword and shield look better than the ones in Breath of the Wild.
Yeah, he has also cheated in the Pokemon games, transferring glitched Pokemon. What was I saying earlier? This is why you should do you. Why should any of you give a shit about what's going on in the Pokemon community? Is the Pokemon community as a whole responsible for any and every little group of specific people in their personal space every time they do some stupid shit? So why should you care? Remember, sentient beings only give a shit about what they can control and what actually affects them.
Oh look, this guy got caught faking a shiny reaction.
Yet it has nothing to do with you. And the part of the community that no one ever wants to talk about because it hurts their agenda, narratives, etc., are just chilling and having fun. You don't ever hear from them because they separated themselves from all of these drama-mongering fucking idiots who only care to poison themselves with the same shit they're always bitching and moaning about. Yet again, they're the ones dedicating their two brain cells, energy, and time to all of that cancer. And he's been doing this for nearly a decade, so imagine how fucked in the head he naturally is, to no one's surprise, other than his simps, of course. Think for yourselves. Fact check and question any and everything, especially the shit you hear on the internet. You don't need a gatekeeper, bootlicker, moral propagator, clout chaser, police, and any and all of these fake heroes bitching to you every single time someone does something stupid and shameful in the community. Yes, it's good to be brought up to speed, but at the end of the day, do we go pouting around every time we hear about some tragedy around the fucking world that we can't control? Do I flake up, run to my mommy's keyboard, and shitpost all about what somebody did three states over from me? And groom you into dropping a like and share on my substanceless shitposts I've been pressing rewind on for nearly a decade, only to disable the ratings? Where Pussy Made YouTube highs the number of dislikes on videos? Imagine trying to prop yourself up as the truth and some kind of savior of the Pokemon community, but yet your punk ass hides the ratings in your videos, regardless of dislikes being naturally hidden now, only for you to turn around and project about frauds. On that note, I guess Wolfie didn't lie after all. Damn, my video is ranked above his too. Oh, look what's next to that shitpost. No wonder the Pokemon community is beyond saving. Here's bad actor number two. I don't know what the fuck a nerf is and I don't want to know, but I do know that he's currently one of Publicify's most prominent humidors. This Publicify simp here is a literal echo chamber of his master. The wording is the same. Publicify even thinks for him. Now all of a sudden he hates Pokemon Legends Arceus. I wonder if he's a furry as well. You know, just because. Oh, but look at this. Here it is, ladies and gentlemen. Another self-righteous dictatorship and echo chamber. Yeah, people really need to curb their self-importance. Look at this morally correct cancer right here.
To play the games properly is the only game in town as far as I'm concerned.
But wait, it's not just his opinion.
I want to play the games as intended by the game developers, and I want members of my community to do the same.
In other words, people like this aren't trying to build any kind of healthy community. They're trying to control everything about you. Doesn't that sound familiar? If you don't think like them, if you don't act like them, if you don't like what they like, well, you get the idea. You will be outed. They don't want to have anything to do with you. That's some healthy community, isn't it? So to build people up, you have to tear them down because they don't function like you do. And Nerth, how do the game developers want us to play their games? You do realize that this is a business making a product for consumers, right? Which is why people do what the fuck they want to do with their purchases. You fucking self-righteous smooth brain. But you're just that anal bead that just came out of Publicify's ass, so I don't expect you to think for yourself or have anything intelligent to say, especially when it comes to you trying to build this so-called healthy community full of passionate, friendly, and mature people. Gatekeeping, dictating, just being an all-around elitist and self-righteous asshole isn't the way to be any kind of healthy and great son. You might want to go back to the drawing board with your use of adjectives here. So there's that literal Publicify echo chamber. Oh, and what is he bitching about here? Oh boy, here's some more of that self-righteous babble.
He stole my content.
I haven't done a piece on this guy in a while. So he's bitching about this guy using his little breeding guide graph to get clicks off of.
It's my idea. I own it.
That sounds awfully familiar. Remember when Publicify projected about people obscuring sources and not giving credit to people? But yet the very reason him and A-Drive fell out is because A Drive didn't give him a vocal credit in a video on information he thought he owned, information from the internet that was never theirs to begin with. And it's the same self-entitled bitching. He just told her to delete the tweet. Hey Nerth, when you and Publicify have a baby, what will you name that bastard? Nerthify? And this is the childish and stupid shit I'm talking about. These idiots are nothing more than clout chasers in a nutshell. They don't give a fuck about you other than to manipulate you. As I said before, there was never anything wrong with the Pokemon community and anything for that matter. It is, again, the oldest clout chasing tactic in the book. Manufacture drama, attract impressionable idiots to take you seriously, and give you clicks and profit. But yet they have their own ulterior motives. But wait, they're not the only ones that should be held accountable, right? So let's see. Pokemon Twitch streamer admits faking a 1 in 16 million chance shiny encounter. If people had the cognitive ability to possess common sense, you could see a 1 in 16 million chance is most likely something that won't happen or ever happen. We're talking about millions of odds here, and people ate this up. And these are the same geniuses giving him money. When it comes to frauds, I look at their simp audience. I look at all of the enablers and hold them accountable first, because you people should know better. And don't give me that "it's just a kid" bullshit. We're not talking about newborns sucking on their bottles watching a fucking screen while somebody fakes a damn shiny encounter. But this is nothing more than a reminder for why you shouldn't be so quick to take everything at face value. Oh look, it turns out that when people fake their little shiny encounters, their gaming device ends up being offline. Oh, and who's surprised that they have modded hardware? Again, any kind of intellectual measures go out the window, and the same heartbroken people end up getting got and are actually upset. But then they'll turn around and blindly support these people as if nothing ever happened anyway, so what is learned here exactly? But at least he apologized, right? I mean, it's still a pretty fucking stupid thing to lie about. Of all the dumb shit you can do on the internet to stream and make a video about. So yeah, Philly Beats You, another clout chaser, did his digging and found that Mitch OG is another suspicious individual who pulled the same shit. This is what happens when you blindly follow people because you need validation. You have serious self-value and self-esteem issues, so you have to attach yourself to frauds like this. Wait, did he confirm it or just do the same shit this fraud did? Just to get that much needed attention. Who knows, who cares, but is this all the Pokemon community is supposed to be about? This is the type of shit that makes me proud to be an introvert. My life goes on despite all of the real problems in it, and that's because I take life as it is, not as I'd like it to be. I don't sit up here and waste any kind of energy, time, brain cells, you name it, giving a fuck about cancerous shit and then turning around bitching and moaning because I can't enjoy any fucking thing. That's out of my reach, man. I can't do anything about it, and it has nothing to do with me. And I'm not looking to confide in anyone just for them to lie to me when it comes to them encountering an alternate palette of a fucking Pokemon. So look out for all of these fake heroes, troublemakers, bootlickers, gatekeepers, police, manipulators, all of the motherfuckers out there that unironically tell you to look out for everyone else but them. They are the ones with the ulterior motive. Drop that poor judgment. Think for yourself, question, and fact check every fucking thing, even the shit I say. Yeah, I'm real good at being sincere because I don't have any ulterior motive. I can monetize my channel and shit post just like everyone else, but here I am, still not making a dime off of any of my content. Stay away from the drama. It's about time we all ignored, myself included, all of the stupid shit that happens in the Pokemon community and on the internet, because 10 times out of 10, any and everything that happens in these little isolated incidents with these select groups of people never had anything to do with you in any way, much like they were always things you couldn't do a damn thing about. So why care?